Hey everyone, welcome back to the Comic Wall. It's me, the Outcast Angel, and today let's talk about issue 35 of Outcast, part 4 of 5 of the Invasion arc. Now, this issue was intense, and especially the ending, and we'll get to that. But what's interesting is this cover. Now, when Skybound first advertised this issue, they had a different cover, and it shows Kyle holding a gun, look, with all these people behind him, look like he's prepping for a fight. But now they have him just, you know, just kind of staring at his hands. He looks kind of sad that they took his gun away, you know. I thought maybe it was like a variant cover. It's been a while since we got a variant cover of Outcast. It's weird to me, and I haven't exactly gotten a response out of anyone yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you guys know. But I don't know. I mean, between Paul Azaceta and Elizabeth Breitweiser, I hope I'm saying your name right, they really knock it out of the park with these, with the art in general, you know? And yes, of course, you're always going to hear me talk about the art. Isn't that really what we care about in comics, the story and the art? So if you guys remember last time, Meghan's been captured, and Roland Tusk, the new mediator for the Fallen, as I call them, because we don't exactly have a name for them yet, he's threatening her, like saying, if you don't tell us where Kyle Barnes and the rest of these people are, with just a snap of my fingers, I can have one of my people back inside your head, like they did before. Remember, she was possessed for a short amount of time in... I can't even remember which issue it was. And so Roland leaves, keeping police officer his police officers posted at her door, and he just says, I'll be back in a few hours. My daughter's in a school play. It just seems so odd to me that the leader of these demonically possessed people is leaving them for a school play. It's just weird. So now we're back at the safe house where Kyle and the rest of his I guess family are staying, and Mark, Megan's husband, is getting ready to leave with one of Reverend Anderson's new flock members, and Kyle comes out saying, hey, what's going on? And Mark's like, I have to go see Meghan. I have to get her out of there. And so Kyle's trying to, you know, talk him down, saying, you know, this is dangerous. And Mark's like, I don't care. She's my wife. I can't just leave her with them. And so Kyle, of course, agrees and says, I'll go too. I'll help. And this is good because, like Mark says, I know every cop on the force. If they're happy to see me, they're not possessed. That's an advantage. Besides, have you ever held a gun? Which I guess that kind of goes back into the covers. And so Kyle goes back inside to tell Allison, and she already more or less knows, and she understands. It's cute seeing them together. It's like from when we first met Kyle at his lowest, living in his old shitty house. You know, he was a broken man. He lost his wife. He lost his daughter because everyone was convinced that he was a wife beater and a child beater. And he's the only one that knew the truth, kind of. And now just seeing them together and working together, you know, it's adorable. I love it because, you know, he's suffered enough. He's had more than enough to deal with. So with Kyle going with Mark to get Meghan, Reverend Anderson actually decides to join in as well. And so they pack up, they get ready to go, and they're gonna bust her out. But we get thrown back to Meghan in the hospital, and Roland is threatening her again, like, give me an address or I will get my people back in your head. And Meghan spits in his face, he wipes it off, and he licks it. This guy is a total freak. He's really weirding me out. And he just says, I've had better. He's weird. So he leaves, and he's walking out of the hospital right as Kyle, Mark, Logan, the one of Reverend Anderson's flock, and Reverend Anderson show up to the hospital. They see him, but Roland doesn't see them, and so I think he probably heard them or sensed at least Kyle, and he just walks off. So now they're inside, and they're trying to find where Meghan is, but of course, probably everyone in the hospital staff is possessed. So, she like the receptionist is like, "I'm sorry, but I'm not finding anyone under that name." And so, Reverend tries to kind of sweet talk her, saying, "I recognize you. I believe I brought food to your mother out on White Oak Pike, right? Such a kind soul, whatever. Can you please just direct us to your secure wing? Just pointing us in the right direction would be enough." But she doesn't like that very much and says, "I think I'd like you to leave before I call security." And Kyle's just like, "You know what? Let's just go. Let's just go look for them." But a police officer comes in saying, "Samantha, I need a security guard to cover my post while I take a." And then he stops. He sees everyone and he runs back to, I'm assuming, Megan's room. And Logan, the new guy that's with them, with Kyle and the others, he runs after this guy and tackles him. And the cop's freaking out. The cop's freaking out, saying, "Don't put me under your spell. I have kids, man. Please." And Kyle gets a hold of him and puts his hand on his head. He's obviously not flinching, or he's obviously not in pain either. And that shows he's not possessed. But in order to kind of scare him a little, to get information out of them, he says, "You'll spend the rest of your life trapped in your lifeless body. You've seen what I can do. Where is she? Like, tell us, you know?" And he gives in and says, She's over there. She's over there. Just don't hurt me, whatever." And so he leads them to where Megan is, and Mark gets a hold of him and talks to him like, "You remember me. I was there on your first day. You're a good cop, but you're on the wrong side of things. Leave town, trust me. Otherwise, things are going to get bad for you." And so he kind of considers this, and so he lets him go. So as they get to Megan's room, we actually find Matthew, Reverend Anderson's son, in there with her, trying to figure out where his father is. You know, if you guys remember, Roland Tusk got a hold of him too, and kind of brainwashed him into thinking that his dad's doing some crazy stuff and that he's gonna need his help. So, while he's trying to find his dad, he's doing it from the wrong reasons. And so, while we get a reunion between Mark and Megan, we also get a reunion between Matthew and Reverend Anderson. And apparently, the reason why he came looking for him was that when you stopped calling, I got worried. Like, you couldn't have just picked up the phone in general. And so Matthew's like, "Dad, you have to turn yourself into the police. I've been working with them. They're worried you're dangerous. The things they told me you did, I just, please, just get help." And so Reverend Anderson says, "I don't have time to convince you here. We're in danger. You're in trouble. What you've been told are lies. Come with us and I can prove it to you." And that convinces Matthew enough to help them escape. And later, Roland comes back into the hospital and sees that Megan is gone. And obviously, he's not very happy about that. Or is he? So they make it back to the safe house, and there's already a fence going up, barbed wire on top and everything, and a gate too. It's huge. And it seems like everything worked out pretty well. Like, it seems a little too easy, to be honest. Now we get a scene where Reverend Anderson comes to talk to Matthew, and he's just getting off the phone from talking to his wife, or as he says, that's my wife. So Reverend Anderson sits down and says, "I want you to understand, all I've ever wanted is for you to understand. I know I was never the best father, and there's a lot of anger there, and it's justified. But there's just so much to tell." Then we get thrown to Kyle and Simon. Simon is Kyle's father, if you guys don't remember. And apparently, Kyle feels that it was weird being away from the safe house because he says, "All of us being here in one place, it makes me feel powerful. Do you feel it too?" And Simon says, "I do. We feed each other the same way we hurt them." And it's pretty interesting to hear. He says, The more of us we find, the stronger we'll be. That's what we need to be doing once we're settled here and once we're safe. We need to somehow find as many outcasts as we can and bring them here and make our stand here. Obviously, they're not going to have that chance because all of a sudden we see a sound effect of a megaphone going off saying, "Attention, this is the Rome PD." And this is interesting. I haven't seen Rus Wooton is the letterer for this series, and it's cool just seeing this the sound effect. It's different from all the other like sound effects and punches and stuff that we see throughout Outcast. And then we get thrown outside, and there's just a line of police and SWAT teams just outside the fence. It's bad. And so Roland gets a hold of the microphone and says, "Kyle Barnes, you are a fugitive from the law, and your occupation of this farmhouse is unlawful and will cease immediately. We will give you 5 minutes to organize your surrender. If you're not opening those gates by then, we're coming in. This can be easy or difficult. Your choice." First of all, why is he exactly a fugitive? I don't exactly know what he did that's illegal, other than not being caught by these people. Well, they did kind of burn down the farmhouse where all those possessed were being held. And then we get thrown back to Matthew and Reverend Anderson. Of course, Matthew was never on their side. He he's the one who called Roland and told them where they are. And Reverend Anderson's pissed. He's like, "You've killed us all." And Kyle's like, "I don't think we were followed. We were careful." And so Simon says, "If we hurry, we may be able to run. They can't have the whole farm surrounded. The fence in the back of the farm isn't complete. We could..." And Kyle says, "No." And the end of the issue is him saying, "We're not running. This is our home. This is where we're going to make our stand. It's me they really want, so I'm going to go out there and face them. It's the only way." And we see Amber, Kyle's daughter, as she's being held by Allison. She has this look on her face as if, like, she's ready to fight. And I'm hoping we get to see more of her getting her powers, because we already seen hints that she's taken after Kyle in a way, and that she probably has the same powers that Kyle and Simon are, so she's probably an outcast as well. And so yeah, that's the end of this issue, and I'm so excited for the next issue, for the last part of this story arc. It's intense, and I'm just wondering how this is gonna play out, because it seems so weird to finish this arc in one issue. We haven't even seen any fighting yet, you know? Unless there's going to be another story arc after Invasion that shows, like, the actual fighting and everything. So, I don't know. We'll see from there. But that's the end of this episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys liked it. And if you did, drop a like, show the love, hit that subscribe button to get more of my videos, ring the bell to get notifications of when I post new videos, so that way you guys stay updated. And, I'll see you guys for issue 36. Thank you for watching. Bye.